Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about post-colonialism theory and the literatures related to the post-colonial studies. So what is post-colonialism? Post-colonialism is the study of the cultural legacy of colonialism and imperialism, focusing on the exploitation of the colonized. Post-colonial theory allows for subaltern people to speak for themselves. So when the Britishers or the European countries or the American countries have colonized around the world when they have left the countries, they have left their cultural legacy into the colonized people. And while after decolonizing, they have a great impact on the colonized society, their literature, and in their life. Nowadays, we all imitate just European culture and or the West, so-called Western cultures. So today we are going to talk about the literatures which are important for post-colonial reading. So at first we have the major theorist, which is Homi K. Bhabha, Gayatri Chakraborty Spivak, Franz Fanon, Dipesh Chakraborty, Ranjit Guha, Salman Rushdie, Gogi Wa Thiong'o, Chinua Achebe, Emma Ada Aitu, etc. So firstly, we will discuss the major books by the major post-colonial writers. First, we have Homi K. Bhabha, from which we have the major book Location of Culture and Nation and Narration. The other books by Homi K. Bhabha are In a Spirit of Calm Violence, Location, Negotiating Rapture, Forward to Modernity, Democracy De-realized, Making Difference, Still Life, Without Boundary, and Midnight to the Boom. So the famous books by Homi K. Bhabha are Location of Culture and Nation and Narration. Homi Bhabha has introduced four terms in relation to post-colonial studies, and they are thought space, mimicry, hybridity, and ambivalence. Third space is when different cultures intermixes, a liminal space rises with something new and unrecognizable. Mimicry is when mimicry takes place when the colonized society imitates the culture of the colonizers. Hybridity is when culture mixes between East and West. When the East and West culture mix, we form a hybrid culture. Ambivalence is the complex mix of attraction and repulsion that characterizes the relation between colonizer and colonized. Next, we have Gayatri Chakraborty Spivak, whose most important book is Can the Subaltern Speak? The other books by Spivak are Post-Colonial Critic, A Critic of Post-Colonial Reason, Death of a Discipline, Nationalism and the Imagination, Who Sings the Nation State, In Other Worlds, Other Asias. Gayatri Chakraborty Spivak has also translated many books. Among them, most important is Of Grammatology by Ark Sterita. And she has translated many books, novels by Mahashita Devi, their Imaginary Maps, Best Stories, Choti Munda and His Arrow. And she has also translated M. Caesar's A Season in the Congo. Gayatri Chakraborty Spivak has coined the term strategic essentialism, which means that when the group of people or many group of people are weak, they must join together to oppress the power or to protest against the colonizers. Next, we have Dipesh Chakraborty, from whom we have the most important book, that is Provincializing Europe. And the other books by Ranjit Guha are Rethinking Working Class History, Habitations of Modernity, The Calling of History, The Crisis of Civilization, Some Aspects of Labor History of Bengal in the 19th Century, The Climate of History in a Planetary Age. And the books by Ranjit Guha are A Rule of Property for Bengal, Elementary Aspects of Peace and Insurgency, History at the Limit of World History, Dominance Without Hegemony, A Small Voice of History, and A Subaltern Studies. Next, we have Edward Said. Edward Said is the founder of the academic field post-colonial studies, and he is a Palestinian American born writer, and the most famous book on regarding post-colonial literature is Edward Said's Culture and Imperialism, Culture and Imperialism and Orientalism. The other books by Joseph Conrad are Edward Said are Joseph Conrad and the Fiction of Autobiography, Beginnings, Intention and Method, Orientalism, The World, The Next, The Text and the Critic, Nationalism, Colonialism and Literature, subtitle W.B. Yeats and Decolonization, Representations of the Intellectual, Humanism and Democratic Criticism. On Late Style. Next, we have Franz Fanon, whose important book is Black Skin, White Mask and the Wretched of the Earth. Black Skin, White Mask is divided into three sections, that is the Negro and Language, the Fact of Blackness, the Negro and Psychopathology, and the another book by Franz Fanon is A Dying Colonialism, and Wretched of the Earth is the most important book by Fanon. We have few terms regarding colonial studies. This is a globalization coined by Theodore Levitt. Globalization is a term coined by Theodore Levitt. And we have another term, glocalization, which is a portmanteau word which is formed from globalization and localization, which is coined by Ronald Robertson. Next, we have contrapuntal reading, which is coined by Edward Said in his book Culture and Imperialism. And contrapuntal reading means a text from the colonizer's point of view, reading a text from the colonizer's point of view or interpreting it according to the colonizer's literature. Next, we have liminality, which is, according to Turner, cultures must be understood on the basis of dynamism and disorder, seeing society not as the thing but rather as a dynamic and dialectic process. Next, we have abrogation. It is a concept of correct or standard English used by certain classes or groups and of the corresponding concepts of inferior dialects or marginal variants. Next, we have a term, double consciousness, which is coined by E.B. Du Bois. Double consciousness is the internal conflict experienced by subordinate or colonized groups in an oppressive society. Next, we have few books which is related to post-colonial studies. They are Vladimir Lenin's Imperialism, The Highest State of Capitalism, and Michel Foucault's Power and Knowledge. In Michel Foucault's Power and Knowledge, Foucault talked about the knowledge of the Orient and the exploitation of the power of the colonizations. Next, we have Uma Narayan's Dislocating Culture. Uma Narayan's Dislocating Culture. Next, we have a term by Derek Gregory, that is geopolitics. Artha D. Gobineau, The Inequality of Human Races. From Artha D. Gobineau, we have The Inequality of Human Races. Next, Waiting for the Barbarians by J.M. Coetzee. Waiting for the Barbarians by J.M. Coetzee. Gugi Wa Thiong'o's Weep Not Child, Decolonizing the Mind and River Between are very important for postcolonial studies. River Between talked about the Mau Mau uprising. Next, we have George Lemmings in the Castle of My Skin. And Trinity Mean Resemblance. And Omen Native Other. Then we have White Mythologies by Robert Young. Then we have Arjun Appadurai's Modernity at Large. Then we have the Afro-Caribbean writer Aimé César, from whom we have Discourse on Colonialism, Aimé César's Discourse on Colonialism. Then the Tunisian writer, from French and Tunisian writer Albert Memmi, we have The Colonizer and the Colonized. From Albert Memmi, The Colonizer and the Colonized. Half of a Yellow Sun and Purple Hibiscus by Chimamanda Adichie. Half of a Yellow Sun and Purple Hibiscus by Chimamanda Adichie. Chinua Achebe's An Image of Africa. Chinua Achebe's An Image of Africa is also important for postcolonial studies. Emma Atta Idu's Our Sister Killijoy, Reflections from a Black-Eyed Squint. Our Sister Killijoy, subtitled Reflections from a Black-Eyed Squint. Buchi Emcheta, Second Class Citizen, Slave Girl, and Bright Prize are also important. Amitav Ghosh, The Glass Palace. Mohsin Hamid's The Reluctant Fundamentalist. Jamaica Kincaid's A Small Palace. Sally Morgan's My Palace, My Place. And Jhumpa Lahiri's Interpreter of Maladies. Ben Okri, The Famished Road. The Famished Road by Ben Okri. And Running in the Family and Cat's Tail. Who is the writer of Running in the Family and Cat's Tail? These are two books by Michael Ondaatje, Canadian writer Michael Ondaatje. Next, A Brighter Sun and the Lonely Londoners. A Brighter Sun and the Lonely Londoners by Sam Selvan. Next, very important and most important book, Imagined Communities by Benedict Anderson. Then we have Empire Writes Back by Bill Ashcroft Griffith and Helen Tiffin. And Alamgir Hashmi's The Commonwealth, Competitive Literature and the World. Declan Kibbert, Inventing Ireland. Hamid Dawashi's Iran, A Pupil Interrupted. Bridget Prine, The Disappointed Bridge. Richard Prime, The Disappointed Bridge. And J.D. Smith's Five Teeth is very important. V.S. Noipal's Mimic Man. Isaac Ahmed's In Theory, the most important book in theory by Isaac Ahmed. Alexis Wright Carpentaria and Bruce Paslow's Dark Emu Black Seeds, subtitled Agriculture or Accident. Eleanor Duff's The Timeless Land. Thomas Neely's The Chant of Jimmy Blacksmith. Thomas Neely, Australian writer, The Chant of Jimmy Blacksmith, and The Only Speller of Luita. Next, Doris Lessing's Grass is Singing by Doris Lessing. Thomas Mofola's Chaka. Marlon James's A Brief History of Seven Killings. Next, Yo-Yo Boeing or Empire of Dreams. Yo-Yo Boeing, Empire of Dreams and United States of Banana. This is a trilogy, Yo-Yo Boeing, Empire of Dreams and United States of Banana is a trilogy by Gyanina Brashi. Amit Choudhury's The Picarder Book of Modern Imaginary, Modern Indian Literature. The Picarder Book of Modern Indian Literature. And Salman Rushdie's Vintage Book, Imaginary Homelands. Vintage Book of Indian Writing, Imaginary Homelands. Hanif Qureshi's The Buddha of Suburbia by Hanif Qureshi. Such a Long Journey by Rohinton Mistry. God of Small Things, Fire on the Mountain, Inheritance of Loss also are very important. Next we have Robert Young's White Mythologies, Writing History and the West. Next, The Idea of English Ethnicity, Post-Colonialism, A Very Short Introduction. These are Colonial Desire. These are all four books by Robert Young. White Mythologies, Colonial Desire, The Idea of English Ethnicity, Post-Colonialism. Fluctuation Between Wanting and Doing, The Relation Between Colonizer and Colonized. Fluctuation between the wanting and doing and the relation between colonizer and colonized is called ambivalence. The Education of a British Protected Child by Chinua Achebe. The Education of a British Protected Child by Chinua Achebe is also important. Alienation and Freedom by Franz Fanon. Alienation and Freedom, A Dying Colonialism by Franz Fanon. Next we have Arjun Appadurai's Worship and Conflict Under Colonial Rule. Worship and Conflict Under Colonial Rule. Paul Gilroy's Black Atlantic, Nation and Narration by Homi K. Bhabha. Chinua Achebe's Africa's Tarnished Name, and there is a play by Gugi Wa Thiong'o for which he has been imprisoned. The book of the play by Gugi Wa Thiong'o for which he has been imprisoned is Nahaika Nadina, that means I will marry when I want. We have Few Natam by Robert Phillipson. Robert Phillipson coined the term linguistic imperialism. Then Camilla Sumsis' Burnt Shadow. Camilla Sumsis' Burnt Shadow. From Camilla Sumsis, we have another book, The Home Fire, Pakistani writer Camilla Sumsis. Tricontinentalism. Tricontinentalism by Robert Young. Amos Tutelar's Palm Wine Drinker. Amos Tutelar's Palm Wine Drinker. Henry Stanley's Dark Continent. Henry Stanley's Dark Continent and In the Darkest Africa. Out of Africa by Karin Blixen. Danish author Karin Blixen, Out of Africa. Bill Ashcroft's Key Concept in Postcolonial Studies. Bill Ashcroft, Key Concepts in Postcolonial Studies. Nestor Garcia, Cultural Hudibras, and Albert Memmi's The Colonizer and the Colonized, Leela Gandhi's Postcolonial Theory, and Azhar Nafis's Imagination on Subversion, and Reading Lolita in Tehran. These all have the effect of post-colonialism, that is exile and alienation. So these are all the books, and that is all for today. Hope you have enjoyed and collected a very little information. Thank you. Goodbye to you all. Thank you.